life I lead in this city. Hello everyone and welcome back. Summer break has started and needless to say, with no tiffin packing, I love getting some extra time for myself in the morning. Some work gets ticked off right in the beginning, but rest I go easy and keep doing throughout the day. Summers are the right time when I give curtains a good wash as they dry very quickly. Since machine capacity is limited, I go with one set at a time, starting with the white curtains. Not to overload myself, I just pick 2 to 3 bigger tasks on weekends to tick them off my list. Last time, I had made nut powder for kids, whose recipe I'll link in the description below. Ghee making is another such monthly project. Growing up, I never realized I would ever be churning ghee like mom. Rather, I remember thinking, why mom does all these jobs? But after kids, a lot of my perspective changed, and then I understood the importance of why mom used to do them all for us. Homemaking doesn't give joy in auto mode unless we find joy in the small things that we do. It can be as little as giving homemade ghee to kids for their well-being and feeling proud about this fact, isn't it? So while the ghee is making, I'll make a super quick, super healthy and high protein breakfast today. I had pre-soaked moong dal for sprouting to make high protein ragi masala dosa. To begin, I'll do the basic masala preparation and make a tempering with rye, chana dal, urad dal, turmeric, onion, curry leaves and hing. Once the tempering is done, I'll add mashed boiled potatoes and add red chili powder and salt. Kids will eat, so I'll keep spice less, else you can add green chili also in the tempering. Mix well and masala is ready. For the quick dosa batter, I'll take 1 medium cup of sprout moong, curry leaves, green chili, ginger, salt, cumin, 2 teaspoon ragi powder and water to grind everything well. Once done, I'll prepare the dosa tawa and get it ready for dosas. The batter should be of pouring consistency and now pour it on hot tawa and spread it gently to make dosas. I used to fail big time in making dosas. I kept on trying until I realized that the only rocket science lies in the right consistency of the batter and the right temperature of tawa. And now I make dosas in all shapes and forms. To add more protein, I'll make a quick peanut chutney to serve with dosas. I'll spread the masala on the dosa and the high protein millet masala dosa is ready. I'll prepare all dosas and will also add the tempering to the chutney. Quick and healthy recipes like this on weekends give more time to spend with family. Ruthvi and Dhairya wanted to eat plain dosa and we adults enjoyed the masala version. Blame it on the company, but tea intake increases on weekends. Karthik will prepare the tea and once cool down, I'll transfer the ghee into the container. As I always say, weekends are my rest days. I mean, of course, I can't take a complete off, but I touch the bare minimum. Honestly, this work is not going anywhere, but this time is. So I value it more. After a little break, it was time for lunch. Kartik went out for some work, so I thought of making a simple lunch of one-pot millet pulao with some variation for Ruthvi and myself. I had pre-soaked foxtail millets and the preparation will start by chopping some vegetables. I'll also use the leftover sprouts to add some protein to the recipe. This millet recipe is a one-pot meal and has three important steps to follow. The first step is, of course, chopping all vegetables and getting things ready. I'll use some whole spices to add some fragrance to the pulao, and to make it more delicious, I'll make a curd paste with spices to prepare the second step, which is making the gravy. For the pulao gravy, I'll start by putting the whole spices first and sliced onion and saute everything till the onions go golden brown. Once done, add the chopped ginger and garlic and tomatoes and cook till tomatoes soften. Add salt and turmeric to pace up the cooking time. Now once the tomatoes are cooked, add the curd mixture and keep stirring for a couple of minutes. Now add the chopped vegetables and mix everything well and cook for 3 to 4 minutes. If you like, you can add biryani masala, but I am not making it spicy because of kids. After that, add soaked millets and water. Give everything a last mix and cover and cook for 12 to 15 minutes. After 12 minutes, check the bottom to see if water has evaporated. If not, cook for another 3 to 4 minutes and close the stove. The last step is to rest the pulao. Do not remove the lid and let the pulao rest inside the kadai for another 10 minutes to get nice and fluffy millet pulao. So this is my healthy and tastier take on millet pulao. One pot meals are everyone's favorite, especially the ones which take less time to cook and are healthy too. The next thing on my list was to grind a few homemade spices. I had dried a few mint leaves to make raita masala. So today, I thought of just mixing everything together and preparing a fresh batch. I'll first collect everything that's needed for the spice mix. Although the mint leaves are dried, I'll still dry roast them in a kadai to take all the extra moisture out. I'll also dry roast whole spices in the same kadai, and once done, I'll keep them aside to slightly cool down. In the meantime, I'll grind the cumin powder. I had dry roasted some cumin beforehand and now I'll just pulse grind it to make a coarse powder. I do not have a funnel, so I just folded a paper to make a quick customized funnel for myself. Now in the same mixing jar, I'll put all the raita mix spices along with some salt and pulse grind it. Lastly, when the spice is ready, I'll add chaat masala, and a quick version of raita masala is ready to go in raita, chaat, dahi vada, etc. I'll label both of them to know what is what. After tea, evening time is usually kids' park time. So by this time, we all get ready to step out, and sometimes I also utilize this time to do some house shopping while Kartik takes care of kids. On our way back, I picked up a few veggies to make something different for dinner. Today, I decided to make baked pasta with lots of vegetables. Dishes like these are the easiest way to sneak in a lot of vegetables in meal, especially when serving to kids. You can grate all the veggies if the kids are small, or make a puree with boiled veggies and mix it in the pasta sauce. I find boiling veggies in the kettle is the fastest and most convenient way. While the pasta is boiling, I'll prepare the vegetable mix, and for that, in some butter, I will add olive oil and onion, garlic and baby corn. Once baby corn softens, I'll add spinach and mushrooms and add lots of pasta seasonings. After 3 to 4 minutes, add the boiled veggies and add salt and pepper. The pasta is done, and now I'll add it to the vegetable mix. Next, for the sauce, I'll simply add 2 full cups of milk and some cheese. While the gravy thickens, I'll prepare the baking dish. I'll take a few bread slices and trim the edges. Now flatten the bread to make the base of the dish. Now I'll add some butter with the remaining bread pieces and mix with my hands to make instant breadcrumbs. Dhairya enjoys normal pasta, so I'll serve him in his plate. And I'll lay the remaining pasta onto the prepared dish. Add some cheese in between the pasta and top with breadcrumbs and bake for 10 to 12 minutes. It is such an awesome feeling knowing that food is cooking in auto mode, so I'll use this time to clean up the kitchen. A lot of you ask me about the kitchen tools I use, so I have linked a few in the description box below for you all to check. 10 minutes is all it takes to quickly clean the countertop and arrange things back at its place. Pasta is ready, and now it's time to eat in peace. This big pasta was such an amazing change from the regular meal and also from my regular cooking, and the dish was over in no time. With kids at this age, it's tough for Karthik and me to get time together. There is always a rush in the house, and most of the time we juggle to meet their demands. However, on weekends, we take the liberty to watch some TV and share the know-how of life. I hope you liked watching this vlog. Like this video and subscribe to the channel if you do. Let me know which recipe you enjoyed the most and share your creations with me on Instagram. Join me there if you haven't already for some behind the scenes and see the glimpses of my day. And I'll see you in my next vlog. Until then, stay tuned and stay connected.